My friends, over the Christmas holidays, the YouTube algorithm unsubscribed about 500 people from my channel, leaving a little coal in their stockings. Please check to make sure you weren't one of those targeted. If you're not subscribed, please support us by clicking the subscribe button. And once again, I thank all of you wonderful folks for these super thanks, and I renew my vow to respond to every single one, just as I do to Super Chats, because on this channel, we are grateful to each and every one of you. Happy New Year, my friends, and now, on to the video. Happy New Year, my friends! I am Dictor Van Doomcock, the future ruler of Earth, and now that the fireworks have exploded and we see 2023 in our rearview mirror, people are reflecting on what happened last year, and I suspect that when the dust settles, 2023 will be remembered as the year that woke broke. Oh, woke is not entirely dead, not yet. Many woke projects are still in the pipeline in Hollywood, since it takes years for a project to move from deal memo to finished project. Hollywood is like a huge ocean liner, and it takes a long time to slow down and turn around. So in the same way that the starlight we see in the sky at night is a snapshot of the stars as they appeared millions of years ago, so too are a lot of the woke projects we'll be seeing in 2024 a snapshot of Hollywood several years back. Sure, the idiots at Disney who have been infected with the woke virus and are now allergic to the idea of profit are committed to running over the edge of the cliff like the lemmings they murdered en masse for a Disney nature documentary years ago. Look it up if you want to know more about that ugly story. But the rest of Hollywood is waking up with a nasty woke hangover from their bender in 2023, and a former Anheuser Busch president is now predicting that companies have learned a hard lesson this past year. Get woke, go broke. And that same former president is predicting that companies are going to be moving away from that divisive political woke garbage in 2024.
Hey, we've tried to tell these morons, get woke, go broke is not just a slogan. It's a natural law, like gravity. Everybody is sick to death of this woke shit. Being gaslighted, brainwashed, bullied, and condemned, everyone watching this channel knows that the wages of woke is broke. But that slogan has little to do with the price of peas in Peoria. The real issue is, have companies been punished for their woke transgressions? And how badly have they been hurt for trying to ram wokeness down people's throats?
Oh, Skulla Calderon, they're hurting worse than Darth Maul trying to take a dump without an asshole. 'Cause he got chopped in half. Obscure joke, but I am hungover this morning. Let's move on. Fox Business published an article a few days ago titled, Former Anheuser-Busch President Predicts Long Road to Recovery for Woke Corporations in 2024. Companies like Target, Disney, and Anheuser-Busch lost big with shareholders in 2023. In that article, they methodically break down just how badly woke companies and brands like Bud Light, Target, and Disney have been hurt by pandering to the purple hair nose ring demographic while ignoring the American mainstream. Turns out pandering to a tiny minority of bullies and professional victims while alienating the vast majority of the public who do not place the rainbow flag over the American flag is really kind of a bad business model. Huh, who knew?
Literally anyone who can do math knew that. A big market is better than a little market. There. You're welcome, Hollywood. You stupid fox. But are they learning their lesson, Doomcock? Are they ready to step away from the woke Kool-Aid yet again?
Harvey Cthulhu, it would appear so. Given the magnitude of losses these morons racked up in 2023, in this article, they detail just how bad the damage has been. Quote, American consumers voted with their wallets against woke corporations in 2023, with many brands losing large chunks of money for their shareholders. Former Anheuser-Busch President Anson Friedrichs suggested that many consumers are pushing back because they are fed up with major corporations telling them how to think and what to do. Bud Light and its parent company, Anheuser Busch, came under fire shortly after it partnered with transgender activist Dylan Mulvaney for a March Madness social media promotion earlier this year. The beer brand celebrated the influencer identifying as a woman for a full year by sending personalized packs of Bud Light decorated with Mulvaney's face.
You know, Helen of Troy was said to be the face that launched 1,000 ships. Dylan Mulvaney on Bud Light cans was the face that launched 1,000 shits. As in, shit, what the fuck is this? I'm never drinking Bud Light again. The closest Dylan Mulvaney will get to Audrey Hepburn is hardly half burn. It's enough to put a dude off his beer. And it did.
Boy, did it. The article continues, quote, as sales began to plummet, Brendan Whitworth, the CEO of Anheuser-Busch, addressed the controversy on April 14th, claiming the company never intended to be part of a discussion that divides people. By May, Anheuser-Busch had dropped $27 billion in market value, and sales were down nearly 30% compared to the previous year. In July, the company announced it was laying off hundreds of workers. In its third quarter, the company suffered a 13.5% decline in U.S. revenue and a 17.1% decline in North American sales volume. Retail giant Target faced similar backlash from consumers after the company featured products for transgender individuals as part of their yearly Pride Month displays. The merchandise included female-style swimsuits that can be used to tuck male genitalia. The corporation forced some southern stores to move Pride merchandise away from the front of their locations after customer outrage to avoid a Bud Light situation, Fox News Digital first reported.
Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Target was selling swimsuits where you could tuck your male junk to look like you got nothing down there? Shades of Jame Gum! I guess it rubs the lotion on its skin wasn't a good slogan for Target, as it turns out. Who knew? It appears that in this case, Target was well and truly tucked. Get it? Tucked?
It certainly appears that way. Oh, Skull of Calderon. Jesus, you're developing a sense of humor.
I've always had one. It's dry.
Yes. Like, presumably, the rest of your body, wherever it lies.
Very funny.
The article states, quote, Target stock took a hit and its sales experienced a downturn in its second quarter. CEO Brian Cornell acknowledged the impact the fallout had on sales in a call with reporters in August, Fox Business reported. Finally, people are seeing that when companies get involved in these social and political issues that have nothing to do with their mission and their stock price plummets, that's bad for these companies. That's bad for people relying on them just to make the money so they can retire with dignity, Freerick said.
And what about Disney? How badly did the mouse suffer in 2023, Doomcock?
As we all know, Harvey, almost all of Disney's movies in 2023 underperformed expectations or outright bombed. People stayed away from theaters showing Disney products in droves because, just as this article suggests, people are sick and tired of the woke bullshit, substandard writing, and rainbow flag obsessions of the mouse. This article is primarily focused on the stock market, however, and so while Disney is breathing a sigh of relief that they got out of the $70 a share gutter, this article paints a harsh reality about Disney's stock market performance. Quote, Disney stock price is down over 5% year to date compared to the benchmark S&P 500, which is up more than 13% in that same period. Meanwhile, Disney's shares have dropped over 29% in the past 5 years and have traded near 9-year lows in October. Freerick's predicted that the road to recovery for a lot of these companies would be long, noting that it takes many years for corporations to build their brands, but just one marketing campaign to tear them down. Unquote. My friends, this article graphically illustrates just how badly woke is damaging not only our culture, but the very businesses that embrace it. What does this mean for us in 2024? It means we are winning the war against woke, and in 2024, we need to keep up the pressure. Stay vigilant. Screw your courage to the sticking place. Close your wallets to all wokeness. Keep sounding the alarm about woke wherever you see it. And of course, my friends, as always, stay angry.